Oh my god, here it is, the fastest smartphone that you can buy today. This is the Red Magic 6S Pro. It is faster than the iPhone 13 Pro Max. It is faster than the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra. While it does have the fastest processor, the Snapdragon 888 Plus. Take note, the Plus, it is an upgraded version of the Snapdragon 888, which was Qualcomm's fastest processor this year. It's a minor upgrade, but it does the job. We do get 850,000 points in AnTuTu benchmark based on leaks. But the thing is, if you're a gamer, if you just want the fastest, the best gaming experience ever, the best gaming phone that money can buy right now, well, I'm not sure yet. I'll have to test it out. Would be too biased if I actually said it was good before unboxing it. But apart from that fast processor, you also get a fast display, which is the AMOLED 165Hz refresh rate, 1080p display. Wow, that's a lot of numbers. It's got up to 16GB of RAM. Wow, that is so fast. It's got a new button at the back, 64MP triple camera, and 5,050mAh of battery. Beast, that is the word for it. So yes, let's check it out. It's time to unbox you. And without further ado, let's unbox this beast. Let the unboxing begin. No. Okay, so here's the box. There's your logo, bunch of swords that make up a mask. Pretty cool. Red Magic. Here's my configuration, 12128 Cyborg. It also has a transparent version, which is the Ghost model. But if you don't care about transparent, here it is, the Cyborg. Oh wow, it still looks gorgeous. You know, after seeing its twin earlier this year, it's still the same design, but let us check what else is in the box. And here we got the documents, SIM ejector pin. We got here the quick start guide, lots of languages, the warranty card, and of course the jelly case. That has a big hole at the center, which is for cooling purposes. And here are the accessories. You do get the USB Type-C to USB Type-C, and last but not least is the Nubia Quick Adapter. Oh my, this is not the 65 watts version. This, my friends, is only 30 watts because this is the global version. Only the China version gets the 65 watts. Oh, sorry, it's 66 watts, by the way, and you can buy that separately in their website. Bummer, sold separately. And that kind of hurts if you've bought this without the 66 watts fast charger, because it's going to be a separate buy, meaning if you forgot to buy that 66 watts fast charger, you're gonna wait for it and you're gonna pay some more. But nevertheless, this is still quite good. Just does not unlock the full potential of this beast. Well, at least for the charging part. But here it is, the beast itself. Okay, I gotta be completely honest with you guys. This is not a new design. As the name implies, this is just the S version or the speed version of the 6 Pro. So I doubt there's gonna be a major difference or major design overhaul for this phone. But yes, just like the 6 Pro, this is the same design, glass back, glass body, rather metallic body. That is metal. But gone is the aluminum back, aluminum body you see on older gaming phones. The trend now is glass. This is Corning Gorilla Glass, by the way. I'm just not sure if it's Corning Gorilla Glass back. Doesn't say in the website. But yes, this is the look at the back. And as you can see, it still retains the original's design for the Nubia Red Magic. Cameras at the center. You also get that black bar at the center. Nubia Red Magic, powered by Nubia 6S. And of course, you also get the fancy lines right there for maybe circuitry, so that it looks like alien technology, like something you'll get on, like the same as the ROG phone. Yes, it does look like a spacecraft, like, okay, that's enough. What am I doing? But yeah, at the back, you get the triple camera setup, 64MP as the main camera, 8MP for the ultra-wide-angle lens, and 2MP for the macro lens. Oh wow, a macro lens. And last but not least is that flash triangle. The phone is very sturdy, built very well. It feels like it was built like a tank, but it's just not as premium as the other gaming phones I reviewed this year. There are much more premium-looking phones, or gaming phones, than this one. It's just this. This is an old design. They're just putting in some of the newer things, such as glass back, glass material. But seriously, this is the same old design. As you can see, they look pretty much the same. The core design is still there. And there has been so many iterations before this. But yeah, like I said before, this is only a S version, so I'm not expecting anything new or groundbreaking when it comes to the design, sure. But FYI, there's actually something new right here, which you can press at the back. That's right, a button, which we can program later. Now, coming at the sides, it's all metal. And yes, it is very familiar from the 6 Pro. Nothing much has changed. It still has that ventilation at the side, right here and right here, both sides. Those are the exhaust fans, the mechanisms for putting out the air, the hot air, from the phone. At the right side, we got here the power button, which is located at the center. Here's the microphone. At the top is the headphone jack. Nice. This phone also supports high-res audio. Another microphone. And at the left side, we get the game space switch. it's back, and it's made out of metal. Here is the volume rockers, and at the bottom, here is the actual speaker, USB Type-C port, the last microphone, and the SIM tray. This does not have a microSD card slot, so yeah. If you want to install a lot of games here, take a lot of videos, pictures, I highly suggest you get the 256 version, at least. Okay, so here's the display. I've already got it set up, and as you can see, it's very, very fast. Well, that is because it has a 165Hz refresh rate, just like what I told you. And that is gonna make everything look really, really buttery smooth. But it does take a lot of batteries, so I highly recommend you just go for the 90Hz refresh rate if you're gonna buy this phone, because there's really no reason why you should go beyond 90Hz refresh rate for the smoothness. Although it's pretty cool to have a 165Hz refresh rate, something that you usually see on monitors that are super expensive and almost at the same price as this phone, which is crazy by the way. Also, did you not notice the blacks on this are just so good, so deep? Well, that is because this is also AMOLED. This is certainly the best type of display for gaming, simply because an AMOLED display really bumps up the graphics, the visuals in the game. It not only helps with the brightness, the contrast, and the saturation, but it also enhances the overall color, making it more lively and just a tad more enjoyable to play with. The display is quite huge, 6.8 inches, 1080p AMOLED display, Corning Gorilla Glass. Just don't know what the number is. But it looks like the same display from the 6 Pro, maybe it's just a little bit faster. Well, actually it's the same 165Hz refresh rate from the 6 Pro, just that this is a little bit brighter of 700 nits instead of the 630 nits we get from the 6 Pro. So yeah, brighter display, better usability under direct sunlight. Now the one thing that you will notice on this phone immediately is that it has a very loud, very, very loud fan. Unfortunately, it's by default. Every time I open a game or just Antutu benchmark, it starts screaming at you. Well, it's fairly okay, but it's not the most silent fan I've heard. It does go louder than this. But thankfully, we have a switch right here to turn it on and off. Here's how it sounds. Okay, fairly loud. It's not new. It's actually in the 6 and 6 Pro. So yeah, there you go. But I guess this is what you want to see. The number. Antutu benchmark. And to my surprise, it's actually way beyond my expectations. 864,000 points in Antutu benchmark is biggest number I've seen in Antutu this year. And like I said, it's much faster than the iPhone 13 Pro, which is only 700,000 points. And it's currently one of the few Snapdragon 888 Plus that can actually do this. Might be the first Snapdragon 888 Plus in the market. I'm just not sure yet, but there are a lot of Chinese phones out there that are coming out with new technology card track. But might as well just show you the games here. Again, we're playing with the game space mode. If you don't know yet, this is where that switch comes into play. Just switch that at the side, turns your phone into a game console, and just toss out every unnecessary app like Facebook, Messenger, all that distractions out of the window. It's just your game. It's just you, which is super helpful. And they have upgraded the UI. It looks a lot more simpler now. Settings are easier to get to, and it's a lot easier to understand. I'm just not sure if the latest update includes a full English interface, because I'm having a part Chinese, part English kind of vibe here. But yes, just like the 6, just like the 6 Pro, you will get unrivaled graphics on this machine. The graphics and speed that you're gonna get here is gonna be way beyond, because it has enhancements that help improve the gaming performance and also the experience. For example, the overclocking here is top notch. If you find your game lacking in FPS, you can easily overclock the CPU or GPU to play the game in its full potential, albeit at the expense of the battery. And as you can see in Mobile Legends, it's always 60 frames per second. It doesn't go down. Well, sometimes it does 59, 58, but who cares? It's still around that number. It's not locked. I wish there was locking, but I just think if you have the 6 or 6 Pro or even the 5, I don't think you should upgrade just yet if it's just for this game. Of course, if you see that your machine can actually still push this game at 60 frames per second, then you will be fine. You don't need this upgrade. Well, of course, this is just Mobile Legends. And the visuals in this game is just excellent. And with the help of the game space, you can actually change the color, the vibe. We do have that setting here in the game space, but I do turn it off from time to time because it's just too saturated for me. It looks kind of unnatural, and it just comes out as a gimmick for me. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. Doesn't really help me that much in this game. And I almost forgot about the shoulder buttons right here. That's right, they're back. Shoulder buttons using haptic feedback, which can be used to map any virtual button in the game. For example, shooting, aiming. For Mobile Legends though, I can't see an actual use for it. I'm sorry, but skills need to be directional, and it just doesn't work there. I guess it only works for the tower lock or the monster lock, but seriously, using my thumb to actually press those is just much easier and more accessible. Thus, I think that shoulder buttons are pretty much useless in any MOBA. Well, speaking of Wild Rift, here's Wild Rift. 90 FPS unlocked. Finally, you're gonna be able to see 90 frames per second in my channel. It looks very smooth. It feels very smooth. Now the problem is, I just can't go back to 60 frames per second now. That's the caveat. But yes, if you want to make use of that lovely, fast, high refresh rate display, this is the first place to use it on League of Legends Wild Rift. But Vince, it's only 90 frames per second. We want more than that. Well, here are some games that actually support up to 165Hz or 144Hz. They're not popular. Here are some of the games. We've got here Bullet Force, up to 165 frames per second. Like what? I'm not even sure if people are playing this game. But yeah, Bullet Force has that 160 frames per second if you just want to experience it on this machine. It is an FPS, but yeah, even though it's 165 frames per second, the graphics is year 2005. I don't know, just that. And we've got Real Racing 3. Oh my, this came out about a decade ago. Isn't it time for a sequel? Real Racing 4? Why aren't we getting that? Instead, we get patches for this game. Unlimited patches every year. And they're beefing it up to 165 frames per second. The game does look quite nice, albeit outdated in 2021. It's okay if you just wanna flex your 165Hz phone. And this last one is actually a good one. Vainglory, up to 165 frames per second. Actually, 167 in my test. Thank God for that frames per second counter. We are able to actually test games on this. For me, it's one of the best looking games on mobile. And it's actually the best looking MOBA game. Better than Wild Rift, better than Mobile Legends. Gosh, why am I comparing this to Mobile Legends? That game's crap. I'm just kidding, it's a great game. A lot are playing it. Now let me just show you two of the best, in my opinion, the best games on mobile, which is Call of Duty and Genshin Impact. First of all, Call of Duty, I know it's a mobile game, I know it's a stripped-down version of, like, Warzone, but the gameplay is there, the meat, the content, the community is just so nice. This game is just top-notch on mobile, and I just think that this game is here on mobile. And yeah, just like the 6 and 6 Pro, this has the access to 90 frames per second. I'm just not sure why it's not going up more than that. This much power, I would have expected it to be more than 90 frames per second. Can't we just get 120 FPS in this game playing on the Redmagic 6S Pro, because it doesn't really add a lot to my decision to pick up this instead of the non-S version. That's right. Seriously, what are they thinking? Oh, by the way, I forgot about the shoulder buttons. This is the best place to use those shoulder buttons, simply because when you're playing on consoles, you usually shoot on trigger buttons, right? Those are quite repetitive. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Left trigger for aiming, right trigger for shoot. Actually, smartphones aren't built to have those shoulder buttons, but this one lets you have shoulder buttons, just not the ones you usually press on. This one uses haptic feedback, just like its predecessors, to achieve the same goal. It's not as satisfying as, let's say, an Xbox controller or PS5 controller, but nevertheless, it gets the job done. And this is something that's not available on many, many smartphones. And you're playing against a group of people that doesn't have this feature. And this actually helps a lot. Makes you feel like you're a pro. Plus that bump in FPS, oh man, that's gonna help big time in competitions. So if you're very competitive, this is the way to go. This is the one to buy. And what can I say about the graphics? The graphics on Call of Duty Mobile on this phone is just phenomenal. It's one of the best looking games I've ever seen on mobile. This right here, it looks like a PC game. That is how well developed this game is for this phone. And it looks like the game is well optimized for this phone. Must be a partnership. But yeah, the resolution, the lighting, the textures, the models, it's nothing like I've ever seen on other smartphones. Not even the iPhone has this kind of quality. Mysteriously, whoa. But of course, the ultimate benchmark game for any mobile phones is Genshin Impact. Oh my, this game transcends beyond any game in the Play Store or even the App Store. This is the same quality, same content that you're gonna get on a console or a PC. Lots of phones kneeling down on this game simply because it's too heavy for most mobile phones. And I'm always like, hey, if you wanna play Genshin Impact, you better play it on a PC or a console, because it's pretty crap on a mobile phone. Like seriously, runs super hot and ultra high graphics, just unplayable at the high settings. So you're only gonna be able to play in medium graphics. But then again, this is the latest and greatest gaming phone out in the market. I could say for the first time, finally, a mobile phone that can actually play this game highest settings without ever heating up. Well, just a bit warm, but since it does have a very advanced cooling system, it really helps big time and allows you to play this game comfortably at very high settings. Look at that. Can you not see that frames per second? 60 frames per second. There is no phone out there. No phone at the high settings that can do this. So far, it's only this phone. Not even the 6 and 6 Pro is able to do this, but I had to overclock it using the game space, you know? But I was like, Wait, this might get hot, but it didn't. Miraculously, it did not get hot. Even after playing 30 minutes of the game, it stayed well cool even after all those times. I'm just saying that this might be the best Genshin Impact phone that you can buy right now. But before I tell you my verdict, I just want to show you some of the pictures that I took with this phone. I know it's not a camera phone, it's not marketed as one. Just like the 6 and 6 Pro, I was mesmerized with the image quality that I got with this phone. I was not expecting this amount of clarity or picture quality coming out of this phone. It simply blew me away. It blew me away because I was not expecting it. Because the camera lenses on these things don't look like they're gonna put out some really good high quality pictures on them. But yeah, I just saw them. The amount of detail are pretty close to high-end flagship devices, pretty close. Great HDR, pretty good in low light. I gotta say, this is a great daily driver phone. Thought it was gonna be a secondary phone. You know, if you get a Samsung flagship or an iPhone flagship, you just get this for the games. But no, you can actually take this out with you. Not only play games with it, but also take pictures, do some calls, business. You might see this as a console or gaming device, but basically it's a phone, and a really good phone at that. And it does have 5G, so yeah, it's pretty future ready. Now, if you do decide to buy this phone, here are the prices. Two variants, Cyborg and Ghost. This is the Cyborg, which is the non-transparent one. We've got the 12 gigs of RAM, 128 gigs of internal storage, the Cyborg version. That is $599. And if that's not enough, they also have the 16 gigs of RAM, plus 256 gigs of internal storage, which kind of costs $100 more, $699. But if you want the best of the best transparent version of this phone, you can get the Ghost variant, 16 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs of internal storage, at the price of $729. Check them out at global.redmagic.gg. Also, if you're in the Philippines, you can visit Shundi Philippines. They are the authorized seller of Red Magic products here in the Philippines. Just go check out their Facebook page, give them a chat, and they'll get you the device. All right. Now, here's the thing. If you want the fastest smartphone that you can buy right now, this is it. There's nothing faster than this one in the market. But if you have the 6 and 6 Pro already, it's not such a good upgrade. It's a minor performance boost, but I suggest if you're coming from a Snapdragon 888 below, like an 865, 855, now that is a bigger margin and it's worth upgrading from. But then again, Red Magic is going to be working on another Red Magic phone earlier next year. The Red Magic 7, of course. I just wish they have a new design. A lot brighter, shinier, and a lot more RGB. Well, that's just me. There are going to be some more gaming phones that are coming out this 2021. Not only this, and if you want to see the competition, you do know what to do. Subscribe, hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my great content. This is Vince D'Amigo from TechBeans, and I'll see you on the next video.